Alola trainers, this is Choconatic. Welcome back to another episode of Pokémon Moon Version. In the last episode, we went through Paniola Town and Paniola Ranch, and we even bumped into Gladion from Team Skull and his type Null, and holy crap, I still can't believe that happened. And I've done a little bit of battling, I made it to this new Pokémon Center, did some training, and now we are just about ready to enter Brooklet Hill for our second trial in the game. Well, technically third trial if you count the grand trial battle against Kahuna Hala. But anyway, let's hop on Stoutland for no real reason and head on in here. And yeah, I got myself a nice specialized team of Pokemon. I think I got the perfect anti-Lana team. I got three electric types and three grass types. So hopefully that'll be all we need to make it through this trial. And there she is, the tomboyish little water type master. Rip off of Misty much? But it's Lana.
Hello, I'm Lana. I serve as the captain of Brooklet Hill. You look like an able-bodied trainer. Could I ask for your help with something?
Sure.
Then follow me. This way, please.
You know I love my tomboys. I'll follow you wherever you want to go, honey.
Let's follow Lana and see what's up ahead. Ooh, I hope it's something good.
Welcome to Brooklet Hill.
Yeah, so this looks like a nice place.
Oh, what am I thinking? Sniff, sniff, sniff.
See if there's any hidden items around here.
Here's a not-so-hidden item, a netball.
Ooh, and what have we here?
Oh, a trainer?
That's weird, encountering a trainer on the trial grounds.
I'll teach you some tricks that guarantee hooking some Pokemon.
The trial hasn't even officially started yet.
There was no, like, trial start thing on the bottom of the screen.
So what the heck is going on here? Has the trial started or hasn't it?
Anyway, we got a Barboach. And of course I got my friggin' Magnemite on front. This was
Hubble. I changed his nickname because I really don't know why I randomly named him Hubble before. Like, I don't know. It must have been the astronomer in me that just
randomly popped up for a second and just made me think of the Hubble telescope when I named him. It was probably one of the most autistic things I've ever come up with, so I decided to change it for something a little better, like Horseshoe for the horseshoe magnets on his sides. I think that is a better nickname for him. But anyway, Horseshoe is no match for Barboach because it's a ground type, so let me switch him out and send in Orchid. My new Fomantis. See how she does. Alright, Barboach is going with Amnesia. And I'm just gonna go straight into Razor Leaf. Oh, right after I get mud bombed in the face. My accuracy fell. Thankfully, Razor Leaf still hits and annihilates Barboach because it's four times super effective. Alright, Orchid, so far so good. Who's up next? Goldeen. Alright, let's switch back to Horseshoe. So we're already battling a friggin' fisherman, but this isn't even part of the trial, I don't think. I don't even know what the trial is. Like, the previous trial with Ilima, I saw... Oh, really? Fucking supersonic hits. But yeah, I saw, like, trailers and stuff. Or, not trailers, but, like, Japanese, like, gameplay or whatever of the first trial. Like, before the game was even released, they showed that. So I knew all about that beforehand. But this trial is completely all new to me. Never even seen video footage of this trial before. So I'm real curious as to what'll happen.
I'm not sure I need to teach you any fishing tricks.
Like, I'm pretty sure the totem Pokemon for this trial is Wishy-Washy. But other than that, I have no idea what to expect. Maybe the trial will involve fishing. Who knows? What do you think, Orchid? Who's a good little Orchid? You were so good out there. And the top of your head is ticklish. All right, let's keep it moving. Look at this background scenery. It's so beautiful. Such lovely scenery. If you don't give up until you catch something, you'll definitely catch a Pokemon. In Pokemon battles as well, if you battle until you win, you'll definitely win. Not necessarily, pal, but it's a nice sentiment, I guess. And there's nothing over here. Okay. Moving along. Follow the cute tomboy. Oh my god, and there's wild Pokemon, and I can catch them, I guess? This is so weird. Frickin' Paris. Like, this is supposed to be the trial site. Why am I battling trainers and catching wild Pokemon on the fucking trial site? Alright, he's in green. So I'm thinking another Sonic Boom won't kill it. He goes for the poison powder. Excellent. I bet he's got like one HP left. Oh, he's calling for help though. And he gets it. Damn it. Now we gotta kill the other one. So let's kill the other one. I just so happen to have Breakneck Blitz on this Magnemite right now. Let's see how much it does to that poor little Paris on the left. Magnemite looks so mad. I am just loving these two new Z moves I got. I can't wait to get my next one. Like, it's so much fun collecting the Z moves and using them. Oh, that's what I like to see. Instant kill. Really? The same fucking turn? You better not get it. It's what I thought, bitch. Nobody's coming to fucking help you now. So get in the Pokeball. Excellent. Paris, the mushroom Pokemon. Mushrooms called Tochucaso sprout from its back. They can be dried and powdered to make a medicine used to extend life. What should I nickname Paris? Some of these Pokemon, I have no idea what to nickname them. What to nickname Paris? You know what? No. Shit, I don't know what to name this thing. I am so fucking... I don't know. I'm gonna have an autism moment. I'm gonna name this thing the first thing that comes into my mind. Paris the Paris. Sure, why not? If I can think of anything better, I'll change it later. Paris has been sent to a box. Oh boy, nicknaming Pokemon is so just... Why does it have to be so difficult sometimes? Sometimes you just don't know what to fucking name them. Luckily, we got the name raider on this island. Like with this thing. Like, I didn't know what the hell to name this thing, so I gave it a stupid name to begin with. But now I came up with something a little better, I think. So maybe Paris will get a better nickname eventually. And there's Lana. What's going on, Lana? See? Do you see that there? Mm-hmm. Look at that vigorous splashing. I wouldn't be surprised to find a fearsome Pokemon is the one causing it all. So, brave trial goer, I would like to ask you to investigate that splashing there and find out what exactly is causing it. That'll be kind of difficult unless I can get Surf. I won't ask you to swim out there, of course. I have a lovely gift for you instead. Lapras was registered to the ride page. Oh, yeah. That's what I like to see. If you climb atop Lapras there, you'll be able to travel over bodies of water. That's right. You'll even be able to reach those splashes and see what's going on there. Oh, my fucking God. So what is causing that splashing? Go see, but don't drop me in there. I'm not waterproof. We got the Lapras paddle. Lapras can swim across the surface of bodies of water. Hold B down while riding on Lapras's back to swim faster. And if you have a fishing rod, you can even fish together with Lapras from its back. Cool. All right, let's register that. You can't call this ride Pokemon here. Okay, so you gotta be right next to the water. So, hang on. Yeah, I can't check the map to see. Before we head out there, I want to see if there's anything in that first watery area of the trial. Who knows? There might be like a hidden item or something there. And I'd like to find out. Right horseshoe. Could be a useful TM for all we know. So let's backtrack real quick. Oh, I wonder if we get like a high definition surf theme when we use this. Okay, there's clearly nothing on that side, but what about this side? Oh my God. Oh, and there's a little hidden island. We're battling from the water? What? I am a fisherman. In short, I'm a person who fishes for Pokemon. We're battling a guy who's on land from the water. You've never been able to do that in a Pokemon game, ever. Fisherman Hal, or Hal, sorry. All right, Hal, what you got? Tentacool. And we're battling sort of on the water, too. Oh, that's... so cool. Look at my swim trunks. Oh my God. That is so cool. All right, horseshoe. Toxic spikes are useless. What are you even doing? All right, we didn't get the boost that time. We didn't get the special attack boost that time, but that's okay. And he is just using toxic spikes. He's playing the long game. Too bad he won't live long enough to use them. Maybe if you had more than one Pokemon on your team, that might have helped you. But as it is, that was too easy. I can't stand being caught. When do I get a fishing rod? Oh, man. Okay, so we can't talk to him from the water. We gotta get on land for that. But we could battle people from the water who are on land. That's crazy. A person who fishes can be called an angler or a fisherman. Yep. Ooh, a rare candy. Not enough space to call Stoutland. So I'll assume there's nothing else here. All right, let's move along. Wow, we actually made it through the grass without encountering anything that time. X special attack.
That's interesting. Hello. I crammed Pokémon in my backpack, bounced around, and now I'm here. Those poor Pokémon.
Okay, it's just one. Mikiko, is that her name?
Ooh, a fledgling.
Good thing I got an electric type out instead of a grass type right now. But I still gotta be careful because if it knows any fire type moves, that'll really hurt.
Flail? Seriously?
Okay, that thing is fucking dead.
Okay.
Bouncy grew to 21 and wants to learn Magical Leaf. Okay, Bouncy, by the way, is my Steena that I traded some guy in the Pokemon Center for a simple Lillipup. So yeah, I'm gonna get rid of Razor Leaf and switch in Magical Leaf. There we go. Whoa, looks like I've been visited by defeat. I've been traveling everywhere too, so I totally get how fun the island challenges must seem.
Okay.
I simply can't suppress the curiosity welling up within me. That's why I would appreciate it if you would investigate those splashes in the water.
Sure thing, Lana. Anything for a cute tomboy.
Good, sir. How are you?
Fishing is a path. It's a battle to win against oneself in addition to the Pokémon.
Mm-hmm. Fascinating. Fisherman Herbert. Let's see what he's got.
A Poliwag. Isn't that cute?
Alright, Horseshoe. Let's level you up and get the hell out of here.
Bubble.
Yeah, I trained everybody to level 20 for this trial. And it looks like that seems like slightly overkill, but it's good, because that totem Pokemon, Wishiwashi, might be real trouble. So having everybody be at least 20 is really in my benefit. Even if I can win against myself, it looks like I've lost to you.
I can't believe we got Lapras already.
I calmly wait for the exclamation mark to appear, no matter how much fuss the Pokemon puts up.
That's how you do it. I can't wait to get my fishing rod.
Alright, let's put Orchid in front for now. I don't want to spoil too many of my... The water is rippling. Do you want to ride a ride, Pokemon? Yes, I do. I don't want to spoil my whole team until the time is just right. But you've already seen a few of them on there. Like I said, this is my anti-Lana team. I guess she doesn't want me to go the wrong way. All right. I wanted to explore the lake, but I guess I'll investigate.
What is this?
It's a Wishiwashi. Can I capture it? It's wild. Maybe I can capture it. Oh my god. I've been wanting a Wishiwashi so much. If I can capture it, I'm capturing it. I am totally fucking catching this thing. Okay, it's got Aqua Ring. You know what? I'm going to try and catch it right now, because if I get it below half health, then it's going to transform and be super powerful, and I don't want that. So maybe this will be enough. Let's try a netball. Oh my god, am I going to have a fucking Wishiwashi already?
Oh, you sneaky bastard.
Alright, I'm gonna ingrain and then use Fury Cutter one more time. Feint attack? That thing learns fucking feint attack? Oh my god. We're both restoring HP now, buddy. Alright, one more Fury Cutter. Shouldn't kill it, but it'll probably transform. Right? It has the schooling ability, right? It doesn't? I could have sworn. Maybe I don't want to capture it. If it doesn't have schooling, I didn't think it could have anything else. I thought that was its gimmick. I'm going to catch it and see. If it doesn't have schooling, then I might get rid of it. Because if I... Like, I didn't think Wishiwashi... I didn't think Wishiwashi could not have schooling. That would be really weird. Or maybe I just didn't meet the requirements for it to activate. But there it is, Wishiwashi. Small fry Pokemon, solo form. It's awfully weak and notably tasty, so everyone is always out to get it. As it happens, anyone trying to bully it receives a painful lesson. Alright, let's nickname this guy. I'm gonna assume it has the schooling ability. I can't imagine it not having it. I really can't. Because that's its whole gimmick. So I'm gonna name it Schools Out. Now let's just take a quick look at it. To make sure it has the schooling ability. Yeah, it does. So, when it has a lot of HP, the Pokemon forms a powerful school. It stops schooling when its HP is low. Oh! Oh! So I guess it just didn't go into school form right away because that would have been too difficult. Either way, I have me a fully functional Wishiwashi. So let's send him to a box for now. Oh my. So it was Wishiwashi kicking up all that water. Even a little Wishiwashi can make such big waves. Splash, splash. Oh me, what is that? I can hear Wild splashing from over there. It sounds even larger than what we just saw. Is it a Pokemon? Is it a person? I suppose we had better go check. Mm-hmm. Can't you hear that splashing from up ahead? I don't even have ears and I can. Well, you've got speakers or whatever. Okay, so this is a big fucking lake, first of all. A revive. Very nice. I don't think there's anything else up there, so I'm just gonna go this way. Look, there it is. I'm sorry, what was your name? Of course, Lou. It is a lovely name, just lovely. Oh, you flattering me. Now look over there. Do you see that? Whatever is kicking up such lovely splashes must be rather big. A strapping young swimmer, perhaps? Or an amazing Pokemon specimen? Another suspicious bit of splashing out there. Don't let any droplets get on me, please. I simply can't express. Yeah, investigate the splashes. Nothing over here? All right. Let's investigate the splashes. We've never even got an official trial start thing. Like, this is so different from the first trial. And let me guess, this is another Wishiwashi. Alright, Orchid. No need to hold back this time. Just razor leaf the shit out of it.
Yeah, that thing is frail as fuck in its solo form. And now Orchid is level 21. It began to rain. Uh-oh. Oh my. So it was another wishy-washy that was kicking up all that water? Hmm, how unfortunate. It wasn't a strapping young swimmer after all. She hungry for that D, though. Splash, splash, splash. Oh my word. Now what is that? Even more furious splashing? It sounds as big as a Wailord. It might be just another Pokemon, but maybe, just maybe, we'll be lucky enough to find a spry young swimmer floundering in the water and in need of saving. Let's go investigate it, Lou. When did Lana get past us? That girl must have some super secret power. Shy, tomboy, hungry for the D. I think I found my waifu, boys. Even though she's just a ripoff of the one true waifu, Misty. Still, I'm starting to like this Lana girl. Anyway. Hello, random fisherman. When the fishing line has been cast, a sucker may come along wanting to battle. Or a trainer will be hooked. Call me a sucker. Oh, this guy's got two Pokemon. Fisherman Carl, is it? A Magikarp. Unless the other one's a Gyarados, I think you're in trouble, buddy. Go Daisy, my Petalil. Caught her on the way here. So let's see how we do with this one. Magikarp's tackle does nothing. And Magical Leaf murders Magikarp. Open shut case. Next up is another Magikarp. Wonderful. This probably won't even give me enough experience to level up, and I'm so close to leveling up, it's ridiculous. Magikarp just doesn't give you anything. Oh, I was wrong. Just enough to bring Daisy up to level 21. Maybe I myself became the sucker? Yeah, I'd say so. How you doing, Daisy? You got all wet from the splash, I guess? Oh, why am I brushing? I'm an idiot. Blow dry. There we go. Feeling better. Let me tickle your leaves. All right. This is such a weird trial, if this is even the trial. Like, we never got an official trial start screen. Oh, there's something over here. Or is this the way to the next spot? Okay, let me go back to the fisherman real quick. I don't know which way is the way I'm supposed to go or not. Having a fishing rod is fun because it allows you to meet both Pokemon and trainers. Okay, this is the next spot. Brooklet Hill. Within it lies the legendary Pokemon said to be the embodiment of the sea itself. The mighty Kyogre. What? Fucking Kyogre is here. Really? Oh dear, you won't be tricked easily, Lou. You friggin' tease. Oh my god, I love this girl. But we are near the sea. If that splashing sound is coming from the sea, then I wonder what's causing it. And now it's raining as well. This rain will boost the power of any water type. Moves by half again. Could those splashes be caused by some Pokemon whose moves are now growing ever stronger in the falling rain? We're going all the way into Brooklet Hill. I don't know about this. I got a bad feeling. I thought we were already in Brooklet Hill. What the hell is this place if it's not Brooklet Hill? And what the hell is over to the right is what I'm wondering right now. Come on, Lapras, let's find out. Oh my god, it's TM55 Scald! Oh snap! We're getting into the good stuff now. Oh yeah, I got that X special attack earlier. And now I got Scald. 80 base power and burns. Oh my god. I am gonna have some fun with that one. Alright, now we can move on to the next area. I thought we were already in Brooklet Hill, but apparently Brooklet Hill is up ahead, according to Lana. So follow the sexy tomboy! Oh, we got the totems marking. I guess this is the official trial site. Blue, you've come all this way with me. Now we get the official trial start. That's right, didn't you notice? You passed through the captain's gate by my side. Which means that you will undergo my trial. To clear my trial, you must defeat the great totem Pokemon known as the Lord of the Ocean. That's all there is to it? Just beat him? That spray of water you can see there, that's where you'll probably find the totem. And perhaps those wishy-washy you battled against will also want their revenge. Defeat whatever comes at you and prove your strength to me. And remember that you cannot catch any Pokemon here unless you complete my trial. I already got a wishy-washy anyway. I'm good. So let the trial begin. That splashing over there, do you think that's another wishy-washy? Defeat the totem that is causing all that sea spray and prove your strength to me. And, well, you may find that using grass or electric type moves will be to your advantage. Or you could always resort to using an X special defense or two and perhaps a dire hit. Do not let your guard down. The totem is not to be trifled with. Right, my team's already a little banged up. Maybe I should heal some of them. Yeah, Orchid and Horseshoe got a little banged up there. Let me just drop some potions on them real quick. Oh, I don't even have regular potions. I just got super potions. You know what? How many orange berries do I have? Yeah, I don't have to heal them all the way up. Just most of the way is fine. Plus, I got plenty of these fucking orange berries. Okay. So now the trial has officially begun. It's raining, it's pouring. And I got a hyper potion. That doesn't rhyme at all. Okay. What's over here? Nothing. Okay. Follow the splashes. Thunder crashed over the open sea. Oh, it's really coming down. Lapras is trembling. Oh, snap. It's school form wishy-washy. Oh my god, that is actually terrifying. Here we go, the totem battle. Oh my god. Go, Daisy, you can do it. Maybe, I don't know. We're gonna find out. First things first, leech seed. Much better. Oh, and Daisy dodged the water gun. Very nice. And leech seed is sucking up its health. Okay, I think we're off to a good start. But now it's calling its ally. A wishy-washy. But that's just a solo form wishy-washy. That's no big deal. Okay, that's out of the way. Soak. Oh, it turned me into a water type.
Now I won't get my stab boost anymore. Let me see who I can switch to. So yeah, this is my anti-Lana team. You've seen most of them, and you've seen Wipeout before. Let's send in a newly evolved team member, Thunderbug. He finally got around to evolving into a Charge-a-Bug. So maybe he's got the power to take down this Wishy-Washy now. After eating this water gun, oh my god, it's so powerful. Even with the leech seed, I don't know if I'm going to be able to tank another one of those. And it's summoning another ally. Oh my god. Alamomola? What? This is getting a little ridiculous here. I thought all it could summon was other wishy-washy, but I guess I was wrong. Alamoma was hitting me with water gun. Use spark. Oh my god. Growl. Oh, it had a berry. Clever. Citrus berry. Sneaky bastard. This is proving to be a tough totem battle. Heal pulse. Oh my fucking god. This is just getting crazier and crazier. Avoided the water gun. It's got fucking citrus berry, heal pulsing allies. This thing is just crazy. This is much trickier than the first totem battle, that's for sure. I gotta take down that Alamomola before it heals it anymore. One last spark, and Alamomola is dead. That landed a critical hit. Wish you got that one turn ago, but oh well. Alright, now he's level 21. Bring it on, Wishy-Washy. And Bouncy is 22. And Wipeout is 21. Wipeout wants to learn Feint. I don't care about that. Water gun again. Oof. Oh my god, that did so much damage. Wishy-Washy OP, please nerf. Okay. All we can do now is just keep on sparking till we can't spark no more. And there comes another water gun. Oh, Thunderbug toughed it out. Awesome. Don't cry, Thunderbug. We almost got him. I know you can do it. You went through all that training so I could evolve you for this exact moment so you could take down this wishy-washy. Oh, so close. If I hadn't fainted. Oh, and it went down to its normal form. Ha ha ha. Okay, how best to finish it off? You know what? I'm going to finish it off with a good old Wipeout. Do it now! Electro Ball! You put up a good fight, Wishy-Washy, but it's over. Get wrecked. EXP everywhere. Ooh, stun spore, huh? Sleep powder has... Oh, they have the same accuracy. Should I go with sleep powder or stun spore? You know what?
I'm gonna go with Stun Spore. There we go, Daisy learned Stun Spore. Horseshoe leveled to 22. And we fucking did it. We beat Totem Wishy Washy. Excellent job. All of you, especially Wipeout. And Wipeout, you're soaked from all the rain, probably. Let's get you dried off. I am so fucking proud of you. And her affection's already maxed out, but I just had to give her a pat on the head for a job well done. Oh boy. Very well done, Lou. Please come back this way. You don't have to tell me twice. I must say that I find myself at an impasse here. All of the wishy-washy that I so diligently trained up were defeated, and that is very frustrating. But of course I cannot let your completion of my trial go uncelebrated, Lou. You were amazing, Lou. Truly impressive. Please take this.
Oh yeah. It's the Water-type Z-Crystal. Now we can really get into some action. Trial complete. I love it.
You do know what this is, don't you? Watch. This is how you use Waterium Z. And that's not all I can offer you. Here. This is a Lana original, one of my own handmade fishing rods.
Oh, yes!
You obtained the fishing rod. I noticed that there's no old or good or super rods anymore. It's just one all-purpose fishing rod. That's very convenient. Nice job, Game Freak. This is how you use my fishing rod. When you want to fish for Pokemon, look for piles of rocks on the water. Or in the water. Fish like to hide in the shadows there. When you see your bob dip under the water, you have a bite, but you won't for long. The Pokemon will struggle to get away, so you have to press A as soon as you see the exclamation mark. If you want to catch any of the Pokemon you fish up for your team, I recommend dive balls. 10 dive balls, cool. By the way, did you know I once reeled in a red Gyarados? You did?
Did you really? Are you pulling my strings again?
Well, what do you think?
You're such a trickster, Lana.
You did a fine job today. Shall I see you back to the Pokemon Center on Route 5?
Yes, please.
Good, let's be going then. And you can always do a spot of fishing later.
That I will.
So if the... Here's something I want to know. If the ride Pokemon are registered to the D-pad, and why, then do I have to manually go into my bag to use the fishing rod every time? Next is Kiawe's trial. It will take place at Wello Volcano Park. Oh, and that reminds me. Did you see any Sudowoodo by Paniola Ranch?
That I did.
They were causing some trouble for people, so I gave them a little dose of Z-Power using my Waterium Z. Just a little lesson for them.
Ouch! Cruel much?
I wonder how they will react now that they see that you have Waterium Z too. Heh.
Let's find out, shall we? I'm pretty sure I saw something that looked like a town farther down on Route 6. Zert! There we go, Waterium Z. And even though my Pikachu Wipeout has a water type hidden power, she still can't use it. It doesn't count. And yeah, we got dive balls. We got the fishing rod. So much awesome new stuff we just got. So maybe we should investigate those Sudowoodos. Maybe, real quick, just to get it out of the way before the video's over.
heal everybody up. And just in case, let me equip the Waterium Z to a water-type Pokemon. I do have... Oh, I'll equip it to Wishiwashi. Good thing I just caught you. I was like, I do have a water-type Pokemon, right? Alright, school's out. Here's your brand new Waterium Z. Enjoy. Oh man, I've been waiting to try out Wishiwashi for a while now. This is gonna be fun. School's out. I am gonna have some fun with you. So it knows Brine, Faint Attack, Aqua Ring, and Helping Hand. Alright, let's go scare the crap out of those pseudo-wudos. And maybe we can catch one? Well, I already have a Bonsly anyway, so... I don't really need to catch them. Oh wait, I want to hear what that trial guide has to say real quick, now that I won the trial. Yes. See if you can beat all the trainers on Route 5. I just beat the fucking trial, buddy. I don't need to prove nothing to you anymore. Hey, looks like you passed Lana's trial, huh? Why don't you show me those gloomy... Why don't you show these gloomy pseudo-wudo your Waterium Z and see what happens? Oh, pseudo-wudo, look what I've got.
Whoa! Wudo! Pseudo-wudo!
The strange trees did not attack you, but went running off toward the Battle Royale Dome. Battle Royale Dome? Oh my god, we gotta check that out. Ha! The pseudo-wudo were off like a flash once they were reminded of that Z-power. Thanks, now everyone can use the road again. Here's a little something in return for you. A mystic water. Nice! I wonder if maybe those pseudo-wudo ran off to the Battle Royale Dome to try to get stronger. You know about the Battle Royale Dome, right? That's the place where you enter Battle Royales. I think I'm gonna enjoy that place. Let's check it out. Oh, first we gotta get through Route 6. AKA Straight Street. Well, where's Gay Street? Anyway. Let me see. Oh, yeah, we gotta... Hang on. Royal Avenue. That's the Battle Royale Dome. Okay. So that's... In order to get there, we gotta go all the way through here. Up this way. Oh, wait, no, that's a golf course. Oh, wait, no, it's to the right. I'm an idiot. It's literally right here. Right? Oh, no, it's a little bit down. And we have a trainer battle. This is probably going to be a long episode. When you speak of the youngster Anthony, I'm the only one in the Alola region. All right, let's see how Schools Out does in its first battle. Magby. All right, I think I know what to do here. School's out. How about you give that Waterium Z a spin? Hydro Vortex, base 120 power with Brine. Let's give it a try. It hits us with Ember. All right, now for a real attack. So how do I get it into school form? It says when its health is at a certain point. I don't know what point that has to be. When it goes into low health, it goes back into solo form. But it doesn't automatically go into school form when it's at full health. Otherwise, it would already be in school form. So what the hell do I have to do to get it into school form? Either way, Hydro Vortex annihilated Magby. I didn't even need school form. But yeah, I'm gonna have to figure this out off screen. Exactly how Wishiwashi works. I didn't even see what he said he was sending out next, but I'll just send in Wipeout for it. Whatever it is, Wipeout can handle it. Oh, Young Goose. I can handle a fucking Young Goose.
Bide. Shit. Hopefully this'll two-hit KO it. If not, I might be in trouble. Oh, how about one-hit KO it? Get the fuck out of here, young goose. Alright, Wipeout is level 22.
You beat me, the only one like me in Alola, so you're great. When I think about it, you two are all alone in the world. Hold on a sec, how great is that?
Ooh, this item is pretty great. A super potion. Could always use more of those. Alright, so we got some grass over here. And what the heck? It's a Clydes... or, Mudsdale. I almost called it Clydesdale.
You there, trainer. Can you come to my aid? Over here.
Yo, yo, yo. Don't go turning your backside on us. And you. You're that numbskull trainer from Mella Mella, yo.
These scoundrels are Pokemon thieves, and you're on familiar terms with them?
Well, yeah, I know them, but not in a friendly way.
Yeah, that's right, you do.
I am Hapu. Life in the big city sure is something else. Pokemon thieves roam about brazenly. I leave that one to you.
We're not thieves, yo. It's a legitimate business. We got straight messed up in Mella Mella, got exiled to Akala, but we ain't going out like that.
Alright, we have a Team Skull battle. I just want to get to the Battle Royale Dome, but I guess we got to deal with this first. Drowsy. Alright, school's out. I really gotta learn how to use its school form, though. Confusion. Actually hurt really badly. But I got Faint Attack. Oh my god, that did nothing. Well, it didn't do nothing, but it's not good enough. We need somebody else. Thunderbug, get in here. Clearly, School's Out needs some training, and I need to learn how to use its school form. Use Bite. Much better. Bouncy grew to 23. All right. Bone dry. With all these losses, we're gonna anger our bosses. These tears taste like salt, yo, and it's all your fault, yo. Flute?
Mudsdale, shall we stomp these scoundrels? It'll be a mess to clean up afterward, but I'm willing if you are.
Time for us to break out, yo. Gotta tell y'all peace out, yo. I'm not gonna keep telling you this, except when I keep telling you this.
Aw, rhyming the same words together, that's lame.
You better listen to what my homie says and drill it into that thick skull of yours. Seriously, you better not forget, numbskull.
And off they go to the races.
You'll be fine getting home?
Floon.
Aw, it's a little Drivloon. Glad to see that one will get home on her own. I've got you to thank for that. Give me your name, trainer. Lou, eh? That's a fine name. I like the way you handled yourself in battle. Mudsdale and I are always wandering all about Alola to try to achieve our goals, so perhaps we'll meet again someday. I am indebted to you for your aid, after all. Ah, yes. You might want to try your hand at a battle royale or two, Lou. Mudsdale here thinks you'd be well suited to it, given how strong you are.
So she's the ground type master. I thought it was the kahuna, Olivia, at first, but now that I think of it, Olivia's probably rock type. Zoinks, what are you waiting for? Let's go. I want to see that Battle Royale dome for myself.
Well, I think that'll have to wait till next time, because this video has already gotten too long. So I guess next time we'll check out the Battle Royale dome. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I will see you next time.